Hi friends, so in this lecture we will study about how to solve the linear differential equation. So this is the nth order linear differential equation. So dny over dx raised to n plus p1 d n minus 1y over dx raised to n minus 1 so on pn of y equal to p of x, where p1, p2 so on pn are the either constants or function of x. So whenever this q of x equal to 0, it is called a homogeneous linear differential equation. If this q of x is not equal to 0, it is called non-homogeneous linear differential equation. Now how to find out the solution of this linear differential equation? So solution means you have to find the value of y. So how to calculate the value of y? So generally in this, we are solving this linear differential equation, y equal to yc plus yp. So yc means it is complementary function, yp means p, that is particular integral. So in this lecture we will discuss about how to calculate the complementary function. So first of all, you have to convert this the given differential equation in operator form. Either we have to find CF or PI. First of all, you have to find the convert into the linear differential equation in operator form. So given differential equation is, so in this we have to substitute d by dx equal to this d by dx equal to capital D. So d square by dx square equal to d square and so on. So dn over dx raised to n equal to capital Dn. So d is the differential operator, that is d by dx. So we have to put d equal to d by dx plus d square, sorry, d square equal to d square by dx square and so on. We have to substitute these values in the given linear differential equation. So substitute in this. So this is equal to d capital Dn. So dn minus 1 this is, so dn minus 2 and so on equal to q of x. So you have to take y common in all this. So you have to write equal to q of x. So we have consider this total value equal to f of d. So f of d of y equal to q of x is the general form of a linear differential equation in operator form. So in this lecture we will discuss about how to find out the complementary function. For the complementary function, we are equating this f of d equal to 0, so that is called auxiliary equation. So first of all, the given differential equation we are converting into operator form. So capital D is d by dx. After that, first of all, we are equating, first step is we are equating this f of d to 0, so that is called auxiliary equation. So whenever we are equating this f of d to 0, we will get the value of d. So d equal to, this is a nth order linear differential equation, means we will get n roots. So m1, m2, so on, mn are the roots of the given auxiliary equation. So based on the nature of this differential, sorry, roots, we will get a solution of the linear differential equation. So if the roots are real and distinct, so what is the complementary function? If the roots are real and equal, what is the complementary function? If the roots are complex or imaginary, so what is the complementary function? We will discuss in this. So suppose if the roots are real and distinct roots, so real and unequal roots, so m1, m2, so on, mn are the different roots, then the complementary function is c1 e raised to m1x plus c2 e raised to m2x plus so on cn e raised to mnx. Suppose 1 comma 2 are the roots, so these two are real and distinct roots, then y equal to c1 e raised to 1x, m1 is 1x plus c2 e raised to m2x, m2 means 2x. Like that you can find out whenever the roots are real and unequal. So similarly, minus 1 and minus 2, c1 e raised to minus x plus c2 e raised to minus 2x. See one example. So find or solve d square y by dx square plus 5dy by dx plus 6y equal to 0. So given differential equation, first we are converting into operator form. For that, we are substituting this d square by dx square equal to capital D square, this d by dx equal to capital D. So if you are substituting this, this is capital D square, capital D plus 6, take this y common of y equal to 0. So auxiliary equation is, we are equating this, this is called generally f of D. So f of D we are equating to 0. Even directly you can write down this d square plus 5d plus 6 equal to 0, or we are write in terms of m square plus 5m plus 6 equal to 0. So we have to find the roots of m. So using the quadratic equation also you can find out this. So 6 can be write as 3 into 2. So and split this middle term, that is m square plus 3m plus 2x plus 6 equal to 0. So now in this we have to take m common. So m of m plus 3. So here we have to take 2 common. So 2 into x plus 3 equal to 0. Again we have to take here m plus 3. Here m is there, m into m plus 2. We are equating these two terms to 0. We will get m equal to minus 3 and minus 2. So these two are real and distinct roots. So therefore complementary function is c1 e raised to m1x plus c2 e raised to m2x. So c1 e raised to minus 3x plus c2 e raised to minus 2x. Now if the roots are real and equal roots, so how to find out the complementary function? So out of this m root, suppose only two roots are equal, m1 and m2 equal to m, then we can write down the complementary function is c1 plus c2x e raised to mx plus c3 e raised to m3x plus so on cn e raised to mnx. Suppose if three roots are equal, m1, m2, m3 equal to m, then c1 plus c2x plus c3 x square, not x cube, e raised to mx plus so on. If four roots are equal, means c1 plus c2x plus c3x square plus c4 x cube e raised to mx plus so on. So in case of general, if all roots are equal, m1, m2, m3 so on equal to m, then y equal to c1 plus c2x plus c3x square plus c4x cube plus so on plus cn x raised to n minus 1 e raised to mx. Let's see one problem based on this. So solve d square y by dx square plus 6 dy by dx plus 9y equal to 0. So first of all, we have to convert this in operator form. So substitute this d by dx equal to capital D and d square by dx square equal to capital D square. So therefore this value is d square plus 6d plus 9 of y equal to 0. So this is f of d equal to 0. So now we are equating this f of d to 0, that is called auxiliary equation. So that is m square plus 6m plus 9 equal to 0. This 9 can be write as 3 into 3. Even though you can find out by using the scientific calculator also. So you can write down this is m square plus 3 into 3, m square plus 3x plus 3x plus 9 equal to 0. We have to take here m common, m into m plus, sorry, this is m, this is also m plus 3. Again here also you can take 3 common in this 3, m plus 9. We have to take here 3 common. So 3 into m plus 3 equal to 0. So again in this 2, here m plus 3 is there, m plus 3. We have to take m plus 3. Here, what is the remaining here? M plus here 3 equal to 0. We are equating these two values to 0. M equal to minus 3, M equal to minus 3. So, these two roots are equal roots, real and equal. Therefore, Y equal to C1 plus C2X e raised to minus 3X. So solve these problems. In case of this, we have to write this 12 is, we have to write 4 into 3. So here minus 1 is there, that's why I put here minus, and this is plus. Use the synthetic division method. In case of this 1 into 4, that is 4, 4 can be write as 2 into 2, because 2 plus 2 is 4. Again, in case of this, directly you can write down that A into B and find. Thank you.